Today we are going to start chapter 6, that is sound. Students, what is sound? Sound is a form of energy that gives the sensation of hearing, that helps us to hear the sound. Students, there are two types of sound. First one is the pleasant sound and second one is the unpleasant sound. Students, pleasant sounds are those sounds that gives the sensation to our ears. For example, music. And unpleasant sounds are those sounds that create the disturbance in our ears. For example, horns of the vehicles. Students, our ears can able to hear the sound from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. Students, we can easily recognize the sound by listening, that which one sound is produced. Either it is a motorcycle sound or a car sound. And our ears can also recognize the sound of the male and the female. Students, our voice box helps us vibrate to produce the sound. When sound vibrates and it comes to our eardrum, then it produces the sound. Student, next, let us understand with the help of an example. Let us take the scale. Half of the scale on the desk and the other half out from the decks. When we flip the scale, then scale will produce the vibrating, and that vibration produces the sound. In the same way, students, ceiling fan can produce sound. When we switch on the fan, it slowly comes to its original position. Then sound is produced. Students, next, source of sound. Source of sound. Sound is produced by the natural and the man-made. There are two sources of sound. First one is the natural and second one is the man-made source. Students, natural source are further divided into subcategories. First one is earth sound. Students, earth sounds are those sounds that are created by the nature. For example, sound of waterfall, sound of river, sound of ocean, etc. So the next one is the animal source of sound. The sound that is created by the animals, that is the animal sound. For example, sound produced by the dogs, by the frogs, by etc. animals. And the last is human sound, that is created by the humans through the different sources. For example, by clapping, by smiling, by laughing, and etc. Students, next is man-made source. In the same way, in the previous, natural source is divided into subcategories. In the same way, man-made source is again subdivided into various categories. First one is the transport. Student, transport is the main source that produces the sound. For example, automobiles, buses, trucks, rail engines, etc. They can produce the sound, and these are the man-made because transport are made by the man. Next student is industry. Machines in the industries can also produce the sound. For example, digging and blasting machines, etc. Next one is student music. Music is a food for the soul. A good musician is a who can change our mind, our stress through the music. And different musical instruments provide different types of sounds. These musics can further divide it into subcategories. First one is the string instrument. Students, in the string instrument, for example, in the guitar, there are wires. When we flip these wires, then the sound is produced. Next one is the wind instruments. Students, in the wind instruments, there are some holes. When we open and close some holes, then the sound is produced. And the third one is electronic keyboards. Students, it is also known as digital keyboard. These instruments are based on the principle of electronic oscillations. Students, on page 107, your answer, the definition of sound is the answer of 16th question. And now, 22 answer. First of all, write down the definition. Sound is a form of energy that gives sensation of hearing. After that, from the second paragraph, last line, our ears can hear the sound from 20 hertz to 2000 hertz. After that, from the last paragraph, our voice box helps in producing sound. Up to the last, it vibrates to produce sound. That is the answer of the 27th question. Student, next, 23rd answer is, you have to write down the source of sound. First of all, write down the define. Sound is produced by natural and man-made. After that, write down natural source. First point is earth sign. Earth sound. Write down the first two lines up to the natural sound. Second one is animal sounds. Write down up to the second line, that is sound. And third one is human sound. Write up to the second line, that is with human efforts. Next, mark as B part, man-made source. First of all, write down the transport. It is main source of noise. After that, write down the examples. Next, students, second part, industry. Write down the first line. After that, write down the example. And from the music also, write down the first three lines up to the music and changes our mood. Next, student, sound is a longitudinal wave. Sound is a longitudinal. Longitudinal means straight lines. Sound can travel in straight lines. Students, what is, first of all, what is wave? Wave is a disturbance which oscillates to transfer energy from one point to the another. Students, let us understand about the wave. Students, if we throw a stone in the water, then there are some waves around that stone. These around the wave is called the waves. These circles are called the waves. Sound is a form of energy which travels from one place to another as a wave. Sound is a pressure wave. Sound from the loudspeaker put pressure on the eardrum. When sound comes from the instrument, then it strikes our eardrum. To avoid the loud sound, put your fingers in the ears. Next, student, your 24th answer is, first of all, write down the definition of the wave. Wave is a disturbance which oscillates to transfer energy from one point to the another in space. After that, write down one line. Sound wave travel in the form of alternate compression and rarefaction. After that, write down the paragraph from 114 page, right hand side. There is a transfer of energy from one place to the another place during wave motion. There is inter-transfer of potential and kinetic energy due to the vibration of the particles. Students, let us understand that how sound comes to our ears. Students, these layers are called the longitudinal waves. For example, when sound comes from the speaker, then it strikes the first layer. Then first layer strike the second layer. Then second layer strike the third layer. This process continues, and at the last layer strike the noise to our eardrum. In this way, sound is produced. Students, when this process continues, then at some points longitudinal waves are closer to each other and some are away from each other. Where the points or lines are closer, at that point this is called the compression. And where the lines are away from each other, that is called the rarefaction. Student, here, first of all, when the points are closer, then it is called the compression. And when the points are away from each other, then it is called the rarefaction. Student, next, how the transfer wave is formed from the compression and the rarefaction. Students, where there is a compression, at that point peak is formed, and there is a rarefaction, at that point peak towards the lower direction. In the diagram, as seen in the picture, in this way, the transfer wave is formed from the second wave. Student, next, characteristics of sound. There are various characteristics of sound. For example, first one is cycle, amplitude, time period, wavelength, frequency, pitch and loudness. These are the characteristics of sound. First one is the cycle. Students, a sound wave travels from one compression, a cycle formed from one compression to the next compression. That is called the cycle. As seen in the picture, the upper, when there is a upper part, that is called the compression. That means the distance between the two compressions, that is called the wave cycle. Next one is the amplitude. Students, amplitude is the greatest distance of vibrating the particles and it is denoted by capital A. As shown in the figure, amplitude is shown. That one is the amplitude, the greatest distance by the peak. Student, next one is the time period. It is the time taken to complete one vibrations of the vibrations object producing sound and it is denoted by capital T. Time period is the distance between the two compression and it is denoted by capital T. It is measured in second and time in the wave is always measured in seconds. Next event is wavelength. Wavelength is the distance between the two compressions. Wavelength is the same thing, that is the time period, but only we denote the wavelength by the lambda. Next one is the frequency and the pitch. Students, frequency and pitch are related to each other. If frequency is high, then the pitch is high. If the frequency is low, then the pitch is low. Then how can these, in this picture, two waves are given. Then how can we distinguish that in which wave there is the high frequency and in which wave there is the low frequency? Students, see, in the first, there are three waves, three. And in the second, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 waves. If the number of waves in the same time period is more, that means frequency is high. If the number of waves in the same time period is less, that means the frequency is less. And the pitch depends upon the frequency. If frequency is low, then pitch is low. If the frequency is high, then the pitch is also high. Next, students, loudness. Last one is the loudness. Loudness depends upon the amplitude. Loudness always depends upon the amplitude. If amplitude is high, then the loudness is high. If the amplitude is low, then the loudness is low. And student, if frequency is high, that means shriller sound is produced. That means sticky. And when the frequency is low, then the broad sound is produced. Students, you can find out the answer of 20th question. Write down the time period, whole paragraph, that is the answer of the 20th question. And the wavelength, full paragraph, is the answer of the 19th question. And frequency, from the second line, the number of cycles up to the hertz, is the answer of the 18th question. Thank you.